What I have here is a demo application. Clicking load populates the dropdown with all my open windows. And from there, we can select the window and grab a screenshot of it. So here we got a screenshot of Spotify and then from Chrome. And as you can see, the image is the exact size of the window. If you have any projects where you might need to take screenshots or work with the Windows clipboard, keep watching. The way we'll take screenshots will be by using Alt and Print Screen programmatically and controlling application windows and the clipboard with functions from the User32 DLL. I'd found a much harder and less reliable way of doing this, but luckily Reddit is a thing and NemByte suggested this way instead. What we'll take a look at here is the User32 DLL. There's hardly any good documentation on the functions contained in this DLL. The one decent place I found was a place called pinwork.net, so if you guys know any better source, feel free to let me know in the comments. The User32 DLL is basically a way for us to manipulate UI and use elements, and is a standard part of all Windows installations. In a new file, I'll create a class to contain the User32 functionality. So I'll make a private class inside of my existing class. Here we'll create three constant integers for the different window modes a normal window has. Then we'll use the DLL import attribute to import a function called showWindow. What this will accept is a window handle, which will be an int of type pointer, meaning it's an int the size of a pointer. Second value the function will take is an int, which will tell it which window mode it should change to. So one variable to tell it which window and one to tell it what to do. The next function we'll import is called setForeground_window and does exactly that. After that, we'll import isIconic, which will return a boolean telling us whether or not a window is minimized. Last functions we'll need from User32 is close, open and empty clipboard. Oh, and also the getOpenClipboard function. A window handle is the identifier for a window. To get a list of open applications that we can screenshot, let's create a function that gets all window names. So we'll create a function that returns a list of strings. We'll create a new list of type string and instantiate it. Then we'll loop through every process. We'll start off by calling refresh on the process to make sure nothing is cached. And then we'll check if it has a window handle and whether or not the window has a title. And then we'll return the list of strings. Next, we'll create a function to return the window handle of a specific window. This will take a name of type string for identifying the process. We'll create a new variable that will contain the process returned by calling getProcessesByName. And then we'll get the first or default item. Keep in mind that this will mean if multiple instances of the process are running, it will only get the first one. You might want to handle this differently depending on your needs. Then we'll check if the process is null and if it has a main window handle. If it has, we'll return it. If not, we'll return int pointer 0. So by now we have functionality to manipulate windows and get the handles for the windows. Next up, we'll take a look at grabbing the actual screenshot and putting everything together. So let's create a static function that returns an image and takes a process name of type string. Now I'll create a new thread, but this is only necessary if you aren't using WinForms, say in something like a console application. Next up, we'll get the handle for the window, then check if the window is minimized. If it is, we'll show it and then set it as the foreground window so it's in focus. Then we'll use the WinForm sendWait function to press Alt and Print Screen and get the image from the clipboard. This next part might only be needed if you take more screenshots than one, but I found it to be very error prone without it. So what we'll do is use the User32 class is to get the open clipboard window, open the clipboard, empty the clipboard, and then close it. Next we'll set the apartment state for the thread to be STA. Without this, I couldn't get the clipboard functionality to work in a console application. Then we'll start and join the thread and return the image. This is all the logic needed to get everything working properly. Obviously, you can still improve upon some things. The function should really be async if you're going to use it in a GUI. This is just for demonstration purposes, but it works really well, especially in a console application. So that's really it for this video. I hope you learned something and got something useful out of it. In case you did, please leave a like, a comment, and subscribe. I'll leave a link to the project down below just in case you want to play around with it.